Ja, Smart Wargames hier. Let's do a Tank Rangefinding Tutorial. A easy one. I will teach you a rule of thumb, a rough one, which you can use right from the bat or modify for your needs. And it will work in authentic tank simulation games such as here. Sea Fury, but also in games such as EL2 Tank Crew. Yeah, already did a video, but I was not happy with it. So I will now do a director's cut, a remaster version. Give me a moment to get into my chat. Okay. Yeah, range finding with optics. Good thing is that tank optics of several nations utilize the same principles in order to acquire range. And yeah, so you can learn one system. And yeah, I also play a lot of games, as you might notice on my channel. Switch a lot of genres, and it's always great to have some easily to memorize rules that might help you to acquire quickly a range. And yeah, this I will show you. First, what is this for principle those tanks use? It is the mils measurement unit. A mil is 1 meter width at 1,000 meters. That is 1 mil. In Germany, you call it also Strich or Artilleriestrich. It is still in use nowadays for small arms and whatever. And yeah, Germans use it, Soviets use it, Americans use it, you can use it for meters, you can also use it for yards. You can use it for inches, but it is a bit complicated, hard to calculate in the head because you need to use some complicated formula. And you might rather use MOA. Yeah, what is the formula? Formula is target distance equals in brackets target height or width by multiplied by 1000 and this divided by the measured mils. And yeah, what is the problem? Why is it not a magic formula? Because it might you m need to know the width of your object, of your target, and that is not always easy. And not all tanks have the same width, and sometimes they're standing at angles. And yeah, I will show you a rule of thumb, so you don't need to know all tank width and in World War II by heart. But let's first start with the German scope. We are using currently the Zeiss drum optics. They are in use by many tanks, and whatever I will show you here also applies to Soviet or other tanks. But the German scope is more complex because it doesn't indicate mils. There is no numbers like in the Soviet scope where you can quickly identify it. So I will explain you the basic principles of this drum scope. If you go in the center, you see a bunch of triangles. In the middle, you have that is the aim point. That is exactly here the aim point. And you have this big triangle. Big triangle, every side of it is 4 mils long. 4 mils. 4 mils. 4 mils. The smaller triangles have a length of 2 mils. And between the tips, it is again a distance of 4 mils. That is enough to measure everything out. So let's say you would have a tank that would be a huge tank that is facing you frontally, and it is 4 meters wide, and it would fill the triangle here. It would be exactly 1,000 meters away. However, not all tanks, that would be rather a heavy tank, 4 meters, not even sure if there are some that are so big. Frontally, it depends on which era, we will talk about that, but if we talk about Sherman, Tigers, Panthers, T-34s and similar tanks, medium to heavy, tanks range from so on to 2.7 meters to 3.6. Yeah, the Sherman is a quite slim tank, 2.7 I think, something around that. The T-34 was 3 meters wide frontally, yeah, right frontally, front facing, I mean something like this tank here. Yeah. And yeah, Panther, it is classified as a medium tank, but it was quite heavy, was already 3.4 or 5, and the Tiger was even wider, 3.6 or whatever. Now you might think, god damn it, that is a lot of data, I just want to play a tank game, and we will basically use a base formula. It is rough, it might not always net you results, but for me it always worked out, especially up to 900 meters, which, because you don't need always to have pinpoint data in order to hit a target. The real guys also not always had pinpoint accurate data. But first let's measure mils with the scope, and you can do the same as the German scope. We will activate like because it's easier to see on the stream. For example, we have a tank here facing almost frontally. It is not really facing frontally, it has a slight angle, it is a Panzer IV, but we still could measure the rear of the tank. It would be something like 5 to 6 mils. Here, starting here, 4, 5, 6 here is where the rear of the tank stops. You could also measure the complete thing, but I think the angle is almost at 0, so let's focus on the rear, 6 mils. That would be quite a close target, you would simply send the round. I will give you, and will also write in the description, but at this distance you don't need no rocket science, you simply send the round. Let's find something more distant. I remember there was some Stuck and some other target here. God damn it, the Stuck turned to the side. Yeah, but that is a good target. That is advanced because he's at 45 degrees. But there is a flank target here, it is hard to spot, couldn't get a better result. And it is hull down, and yeah, hull down somewhat 4 mils flank, 4 mils flank, yeah, 90 degrees angle, and hull down center mass would be somewhere here, 4 mils. Let's take a look at something else here. Stuck, almost 90 degree flank, almost 8 mils, yeah, 4 plus 4, you could almost fill 2 big triangles or 4 smaller triangles. It is almost 90 degrees, 8, okay. So what is my recommendation? We will start with a tank facing you frontally. Either it is driving away from you or it is coming at you. I have no better result currently, that would be basically this tank here. This tank is almost facing us, yeah. And it goes like this. It is not entirely correct. It is based on experience. I also found this table on a STA forum where somebody wrote it down, and it works, yeah, it works. It is not really entirely linear, but those values work. They are basically for medium tanks. If you would fight early war with fight a lot of smaller tanks, you might modify this formula. But most of us fight this Panzer IV, T-34, Josef Stalins, Germans, Tigers, Panthers. And for this stuff, you will assume around 3 meters tank front width, because most tanks are close to this 3 meters. And yeah, we will measure it. We will start 5 mil, 500 meters, 4 mil, 700 meters, 3 mil, 900 meters, 1000, 2 mil, 1500 meters, 1 mil, yeah, good luck. Now you might say, wait, 3 mil, why 900? You said 1000, yeah, because we not entirely go with the linear formula that normally mill is providing you. Normally it would be 3 mil, if the target is 3 meters wide, it would be 1000, but it is simply an experience value because some tanks, like the Sherman, are a bit smaller. You might also encounter smaller Soviet tanks or whatever. But you could also use for 3 mil 1000. Yeah. I use 900. And yeah, it works. But if you notice that the shots fall short, I will write it down in the description. So let's start with this tank. We already measured it out. The rear of the tank, yeah, here's the right track, here's the left track, about 5 to 6 mil. Which, according to this table, means 5 plus mil, or you could also go 6 plus mil, but 5 works as well. 5 plus mil is equals 500 minus meters. You don't need to adjust anything. I usually write, if you see me streaming this game, I usually write with something like 400, 500 by default. You simply go center mass and center round, yeah, and we'll hit. Why center mass? A, center mass is always a good start. If you, because this is really a rough formula, and if you misjudge, yeah, the round has some room to still hit your target, yeah, below, to if it is going below or going above. If you would aim, I don't know, something like this, yeah, very low or very high, you might risk overshooting, undershooting the target. That is fine if you already have a good feeling for the gun, a good instinct, you can immediately go for those weak point hits, but also there's also, you can also consult some authentic manuals for the Germans. They wrote some quite entertaining short manuals called Panther and Tigerfiebel, where they use a lot of jokes and whatever, and they also often like to keep it simple, keep center mass, and then you can, the second round, you can still adjust. Watch out, don't crash my game here. Okay. And even if this thing would be now 6 mil, yeah, or 7 mils, 8 mils, 9 mils, doesn't matter, simply center round. At this close range, the ballistics are so flat that you will hit your target, especially with AP rounds. However, watch out that you don't overshoot. AP rounds in World War II also still had, they were not of this high velocity like those modern rounds. They still have a curved trajectory. If a tank is very close to you and you would aim at the tip of the turret for some reason, you want to hit the side of the turret, you might still risk to overshoot. Usually if something comes very close by and I, for example, want to hit the known tank hatch of the T-34, I always aim a bit lower. But if you center mass, it's always good. And yeah, this target is, as we measured, somewhat in the rear, yeah, 6 mils. As everything 5 plus mils, simply center mass and send it. Or go a bit lower if it is really very close. You don't need to do anything at this range. Now let's find a bigger target that is more far away and that has a different facing. You might say, okay, but not all tanks are facing me frontally. What is if a tank drives like this Stuck here, armor is facing me 90 degrees. This is a tank flank. And here, rule of thumb 2, I always use tank flank is twice tank front. Yeah. So if you have tank front 3 meters, tank flank 6 meters. And that is not always true. There are tanks that are of course longer. Many of them are longer, some of them are shorter, but it works. Simple rules. Yeah, you don't always have your Wikipedia open. So the same you can do for the mils. Yeah. Let's measure it. Yeah, almost exactly 8 mils. Yeah. 4, 8 mils. Divided by 2, we would guesstimate a tank front of 4 mils. What did we have? What did we calculate for a range for 4 mils? I again use this table. 5 plus mils is 500 minus meters, 4 mils with 700, 3, 900, 2,500, 1,400, whatever. And one, and yeah, so if here we would look for a target solution for 4 mils or tank flank 8 mils, and I set 700 meters, let's set it 700. Center mass, center round, and you see it is almost on spot of the reticle. Even if you, without knowing exactly the distance. Now, further difficulty. Now you say, okay, I know how to attack tanks that drive exactly at me or drive away from me, or tanks that drive exactly 90 degrees to me or 90 degrees away from me. What if I encounter a tank like the Stuck that is 45 degrees situated to me? Well, all this mil stuff and distance stuff is linear. Yeah, it is raising or lowering linear. So instead of duplicating the value, you multiply it by 1.5. So let's first measure it out. It is 6 mils. 6 mils in this 45 degree thing. So in order to return to our front facing formula, it would be 4 mils. Yeah? 6 mils divided by 1.5 is 4 mils. For 4 mils, wait. Yeah, exactly. 4 mils. 700 set. Send. Center mass. Almost on spot. Now, behind him there's a tank. I couldn't really measure it, but I measured something like... this is a hull down tank. You only see the turret. Something like 2 mils. Perhaps a bit more, 2 mils would be 1,500, but that might be. Yeah, let's set it 1,500. I mean, I measured 4 mils, but it is exactly 90 degrees side angled. As a tank flank, a tank facing us with its flank. Yeah, 90 degrees, so we will divide it by 2. Should we having 2 mils, for 2 mils we had this 1,500. He's a hull down a bit. Let's try it out. Over. Impact. Yeah, he's not exactly 1,500, it's a bit far away. So, Stuck approaching 4 mils, 700. Quickly align. 700 set. Send. Hit. Schnell, Stuck. Poor Stuck. Yeah. He was almost facing us frontally. We quickly guesstimated and using this rule of thumb, 4 mils. This is working best up to 900. Yeah. Farther targets, the formula will become, of course, more and more inaccurate, because those margin errors will become more and more significant. And yeah, 1,500 is always difficult. But you will have a good starting thing, yeah? You will good. For example, here you might have absolutely no idea how far he is, and Mike, you send your first round here, your second round here, but even at longer distances, it might give you already a good guesstimate, and then you can range in quite fast. Okay, another thing is, there is this, sometimes some people know it from multiplayer games, I think like Red Orchestra or whatever, it's called a noob method sometimes, machine gun ranging. I use it sometimes for targets that are hard to measure, like infantry, yeah, here support weapons, I think I saw somewhere a support weapon, is that a support weapon? Let's assume this, I don't know what this is here, this thing here. Let's assume that is some sort of support web. You would have absolutely no idea how wide it is. The German optic offers, if you rotate it to the end, you will see the scale will start again and you're in machine gun mode. Let's assume, guesstimate 600 meters. It's a bit far. Okay. And then you can use this value you acquired, for whatever, 700 meters, set your gun to it and fire. You might save a bit of ammunition with that. Yeah. For tank combat it is quite, of course, cumbersome because you need to rotate the entire scope, and you might also have the problem that you get unrevealed, yeah, by firing this machine gun. That is often in multiplayer, I don't know in which games, I think Red Orchestra, they often did that in post-scriptment perhaps as well, people firing with a machine gun at you because they can't measure properly. And then you can tell, oh, okay, some Jimmy acquired me. Good. And about the Soviet tanks. We'll show you quickly the Soviet scope. How there are very different scopes as for the Germans, but usually those triangles are always the same. And for example, for the T-34, let's quickly jump into it. You will also have a mil scale, which you can use for the same purpose. The Soviet scopes are a bit more basic. They often have only dashes for 4 mil. So distant ranging is quite difficult, and you need to mark eyeballing. You need to eyeball it. There are some scopes, I think, where the modders here added some single mils. But other than that, you have those 4 mil steps. You will see it any second. Good. Sniped, but we will work with the scope. And you see two lower scales. They are for the ammunition. Set it to... Right. Set it to something like 500 I usually use. That is for AP and HE and whatever fragmentation. Important is this scale here. Yeah. That is the mil scale. 4 mil, 8 mil. Yeah. So if a tank would be bigger than that frontally, you would have 5 mils. If it would be something like this here, you need to eyeball it here in the middle. 2 mil, that would be 1 mil. You see, it is not easy to do it precisely, but with the rule of thumb, you can still pull it off. And yeah, everything about 5, 6 mil, simply sent around. Yeah. Frontally. Yeah. Side, if you apply this by 2 rule, it would be, of course, 12. So if a tank flank is bigger than 10 mil, then you can simply send around. Because at this close distance, you will hit your target. So don't measure a lot around and fire. So again, about this rule of thumb table. Yeah, I said 5 plus mil is basically 500 and lower meters. So simply send around. As you have your scope zero, your optic zeroed. 4 mils was 700 meters, 3 mils was frontally, and then you can multiply for those different target angles. 3 mils, 900, 2 mils, yeah, 1500. And you see it is not entirely linear. Yeah, 3 mil, it is, for example, 1500. 2 mils is for a 3 meter tank, might be sometimes good because there at this range this round is almost coming from above. So if you have a bit more range, you might have a better chance. Also at this distance you might fight something, some heavier stuff. You wouldn't fight some light tank at 1500 meters. Perhaps that's the reason why they added a bit there. But if you play early war, yeah, where they only drive those light tanks or whatever, those tanks of course they are slimmer. You might take away some, I don't know, 100 meters from those mills, yeah, because most tanks won't get close to the 3 meters average of front tank width. So I will write it down in the description. But always keep in mind what floats your boat. Yeah, that is a basic principle. It will work for you, especially if you're new to those tank games and want to have some quick method to fight tanks. And up, I tell you, up to 1000 meters, you will hit almost. You have a, with some training, you will have a very high first hit probability. And if not that, then the second round usually will hit. And yeah, but be advised to Mike to modify it. If you only fight King Tigers and whatever, some Landkreuzers, you might also need to modify this rule of thumb formula. Okay, that's it.